This is gonna be so relaxing. I don't have to like fucking yeah, you don't have to wrangle a website or players or anything.
Yeah, we
I
don't
kind of
we don't yeah we don't have to yeah
play.
We don't actually have to do a whole lot of work other than host the venue for them. This is pretty good. We did all the hard work already. It's done.
Yeah.
We did all the hard work. It's done.
The hard work was getting everybody here right now, and then also running these stupid events for the last year. And now we get to just rest on our fucking laurels.
Yeah. It'll be really fucking good.
Should have gotten takeout for this.
There's still probably time.
There probably is. I don't know. Fast food tastes better when it's late at night, so right. I'll probably just go and get something afterwards again anyway. Yeah.
This shouldn't take that long. Unless they're all like mega. Well, they are kind of mega cracked.
Yeah. I imagine this will take about the same amount of time
as a regular brand.
Well, yeah, it'll probably be a little bit earlier, but I imagine it'll be going until, like, 8 or 9, at least. Because the first 10 is going to take, what, like, half an hour, 45 minutes, maybe? And then
yeah,
the 5v5 is probably another hour and a half. In somethingawful.com, the forums at somethingawful.com,
yeah,
there's a thread that's been going for a million fucking years. That's just like a making fun of Trump thread.
Yeah.
And since about 4 this afternoon, it has gotten
yeah,
500 messages.
I imagine. Posted this around everywhere. And all right, Tux, you're here. Welcome.
Yeah.
All right. Looks like the here's all gang. I'm gonna make the lobby now. Suevis. Alright, rensenware is good to go. Rensenware is already here.
Boom.
It'll get started once I've done the intros and Tux and Rensen and Tux and the Vulture are both here. Okay, McHerpyDerps has DM'd something to me. I'm going to read this out loud because I think this is funny. Before we start, I want you to know that someone is side-betting between me and Wagner. The one on the winning team is getting a kid's meal from a place of their choice.
Some of those places are legit. Like I don't want a giant, big giant whatever main meal. Just give me a kid's meal.
Let me see. Before we get into the weeds, let me Google. Before we get into the weeds, really quickly, let me just take a look at what's the current Happy Meal. Current Happy Meal toy. Happy Meal. I don't know who this is. These aren't toys. These are activity sheets.
Related?
These are activity sheets from I'm assuming a show called Karma's World.
Even related?
I'm assuming it says Happy Meal toys. Okay. Yeah.
I mean,
that's what it is. It goes to toys. So each toy comes with activity pages, a pencil, stickers, and a punch out.
That ain't shit.
Yeah, when
I was a kid, we got fucking kids' meals. It was like a goddamn transformer in there.
When I got a Happy Meal toy, it was like a Sonic LCD video game, right?
I wonder if any of those are actually like worth ridiculous amounts, because like every kid on the planet just abuses them, and so the ones that are actually in good shape are like...
I still have two of them, I think. I have the Shadow the Hedgehog one, and then I have the Tails one, I think.
I can totally see some of these just being dumb expensive because of how kids are with things.
Yes. Yeah, that is true. All right, we'll let it rock now. So good evening,
everybody.
Imagine
being 8 and having like the wherewithal of like just like addicting your Happy Meal toys.
I feel like most those kids like swallow them or poop them out or something at some point.
More realistically, it's your 8 throw and, them and a, your parents. Yeah. Your parents just takes the second. The Wadon copies of whatever toy you ended up with.
Yeah, throw them against the wall or something.
And then, like, just add, your parents act the Wadon toys.
Alright. Good evening, everybody. It is 6:04 p.m. on the West Coast, Pacific Standard Time. Thank you guys all for tuning in, and for all the players, thank you guys for showing up on time. That was the hardest part of the event. I'm like the Iron Man. I'm joined by my co-admin Kimberly, aka Dedipus.
Indigo is not a real color.
See.
Yeah, it's not a real color.
Okay.
See.
All right. We're 3 for 3. We're 3 for 3.
Okay.
It exists as part of the spiel to like make it 7.
So. So we're here. And of course, my co-commentator Tuxdev. That's the other guy. So we are
the guy who named the rainbow was really really into there being 7 colors.
Well, no, there's
exactly.
Okay, so we're here with Mild West Postgrad Guilty Gear xxac+r edition. So. Wait, no, don't start. Don't start yet. Oh, well, that's okay.
Here we are.
I guess that, yeah. Go, yeah, alright, fine.
Here we are.
Fine, alright, that's fine.
I started a prediction.
They're already good to go. I'll just discuss the event as they play their first game. So this is rensenware. So this is, Mild West Postgrad is the culmination of basically a year, of Mild West plus R events. So we started this literally like last March. And after a year we have like gathered like the best of people that we have banned from the event. basically, and we've got them together, and they're gonna be playing a bunch of exhibition sets for you guys. The first set we have here tonight is a first attempt between Rensenware and JustVulture. So these two are not actually, they have graduated events, but they have not graduated Mild West. The story behind this grudge match is pretty goofy. It's basically Jason Riot's fault. You can blame Jason Riot.
As are many things.
Yeah. So the short of it is that once upon a time, JustVulture and Rensenware played a sixth place tiebreaker where the winner got fifth place, loser got sixth place. The winner also got $3 from the match arena. JustVulture won that tiebreaker 3-2. Rensenware has promised that JustVulture will be boiled in oil, alhamdulillah. Right now, it looks like JustVulture is taking the lead here in this first attempt, though. So, JustVulture takes game one.
Game one down.
Yeah.
But who pays out fifth?
Well, okay, I'm gonna. Okay. All right, here. So yeah.
Second place. Yeah. And then a bunch of other shit cascaded.
Yeah. So here's the long story. Jason Riot did not want to be paid out or put on the top eight scorecard for getting second place. All right, and then third place also abdicated because there was, the short of it. You remember this? So the Jack Wachter and Duck Lennon ruined the spectate client for us, and since Wachter was, I believe, the third place participant, he also abdicated his prize money. So second place went to Stone, who was the real, who was fourth place, I think. And then we had to play the fifth place tiebreaker.
I have a really, really easy solution to this problem. That's Summer League winner take all.
Well, no.
Yes.
Well, okay, so one, Vi would have gotten mad at me if I had done that. So no. Two, this was way funnier, and it ended up leading to one of the best plus R sets I had ever seen. So, and it also led to this crew, to this part of the crew battle event. So this was good. All right, so Rensenware taking round one of game two. Also, I gotta say, JustVulture's username is godlike. Okay, yeah, run up. You can't hail that mix. Turbo fall, lightning legs. Well, I don't know why I called it that. That's Street Fighter on the brain, I guess. This should be
this. I want to eat fried Vulture.
Oh,
I
no!
Have a policy of not eating scavenger.
Okay,
yeah! Who knows what they ate, and you're eating now what they ate.
Alright. So, currently, we are now tied. This is a pretty good early start. Yeah, that was unironically that set, which got streamed only to a handful of people, because I played it out and I watched it after I had turned the stream off. Uh-huh. I ended up putting the replays onto the YouTube channel, youtube.com/lightTheIronMan, youtube.com/c/lightTheIronMan, if you guys want to check that out.
I don't remember this.
Yeah.
I don't think I was there.
You were there for the Duck Lennon fiasco. I don't think you were there to watch the actual sets.
I also remember completely forgetting about that like 2 weeks later.
Yeah. It was really hype.
What was this?
Yeah, it was genuinely some of the best plus R I've seen ever. Better than like most like top level grand finals. It was really fucking good. Okay, yeah. We're seeing top some of that here where we're seeing like really godlike footsies come out, because really you don't want to get hit by Cliff. If you're Milia, you don't want to get hit by Cliff.
No.
And if you're Cliff, you don't want to get knocked down by Milia. Incidentally, I think we have three Cliffs participating in tonight's event.
Sounds about right, considering how stuff goes.
Right,
we had infinite Cliffs in the first place.
Yeah. So I'll go over the team roster while we're here. So, Team Izzy is led by Captain Izzy, who's switched off of Potemkin to Cliff. With the team, with teammates Joefish, who plays Anji, Wagner, who plays both Abba and Chip, Barbaros, who plays Slayer, and JustVulture, who we see here. Team Jacob is led by Captain Jacob, who plays Kai. Dukjohn showed up at the last possible minute to determine his eligibility for the event, so that's another Cliff. McHerpyDerps, plays Faust.
This is the wrong team. What happened to Team Cliff?
BeeBrother, who plays Zappa, and rensenware, who we see here.
It would have been Team Cliff. They were discussing this earlier. It would have been Team Cliff if Izzy had won the first World
Well, no,
five.
She did. Well, she did win, but she decided not to put Dukjohn on her team because she didn't know
right.
if Dukjohn was going to show up. So that was. But it would, yes, it would have been Team Cliff. It is still, there is still two Cliffs, but she would have had the trifecta.
It's like a broken G-Man here.
Yeah. Oh, man. I remember watching Umineko with you, Kim, and every time something happened with the Cliff, I was just like, that's the same Cliff?!
Yep.
Over and over.
Same Cliff.
It's the same Cliff. Umineko, handshake emoji, plus our players being afraid of Cliffs.
Mm-hmm.
What a...
I didn't realize he could hold
Yeah, what a delay.
That looks really goofy.
Yeah. Rensen was not...
Like, you do
that.
Your thing over there.
I'm just gonna go like this.
And if you get hit...
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so rensenware are looking really good so far.
Very decisive lead.
Yeah.
How about like tennis set rules? That how about that?
Tennis?
You do tennis set.
Oh god, that would be whack. That would be fun to do at some point, but...
Okay. Oh, okay. Full back there.
I mean, what it is, it's the first to six, but like,
yeah.
You have to be two ahead to win.
Right.
Okay, yeah. Rensen is definitely like feeling a lot better about the. Again, a lot of people are really scared of Cliff currently, due in no small part to T5 helping the other Cliff players advance the meta. Pretty substantially.
Should be a scared Cliff. Those buttons are gigantic.
Yeah. But it seems like Rensen has kind of overcome and seems to
need a bit
getting,
of a warm-up
yeah.
game in the first game, but seems to have figured it out.
Yeah. We'll see. This is again. There are at least, and there are anywhere from 7 to 18. 19 sets that could be played tonight between these two, so not including the crew battle, so we'll see if we'll see how Vulture
really
feels. Yeah.
I should use that button more. I should play this game more, but particularly use that button more. Souls isn't as good though, like in the more classic set.
Okay, yeah. Backdashing, respecting pin a little bit too much. DK Badmoon, Oki, 2S, force suspend burst. Yeah. Yeah. Rensen's... this, one of the big things was that Rensen, in the original version of this, was dropping a lot of his combos. But...
Hey, there's a perfect! That!
Yeah. Definitely, yeah, going for better Oki this time. Converting on each touch.
I still want to see that double
really
perfect.
Well.
I still haven't seen a double perfect yet.
Alright. These guys are competing for a decent prize pool, by the way. There's currently $110 in the pot. I'm probably going to split
it.
Shocking. Yeah.
Well,
I put in 60, and then someone else put in 50. Which is pretty decent. Yeah.
That's how it is.
Which is... So I mean, initially I was just like, okay, we'll just give each winner $10. But, shout-outs to Formal Eli, who contributed an additional $50. So I think I'm going to try to split it up so that everyone gets paid something. But also, if you guys want to contribute to the pot, !MatchReno, you don't have to, but if you guys want to see these players get a little something-something for their time here, you guys can chip in. But you have sponsor quests, and you can also directly contribute to the pot. Oh no! He got counter hit by Pin through the super.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, good burst bait.
No burst for you.
Yeah. Around the world, it's a side switch and the force break disc. That's a dead cliff.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're halfway there.
Blend.
Cliff does in fact blend.
Yeah.
It's official. Cliff does blend.
Yeah. We are currently halfway there. We're gonna figure out how this is gonna go down. Again, this is a long format. So anything? Oh my God! Okay, JustVulture the Strive player. I actually shouldn't say that anymore because I've been playing a lot of Xrd lately, and the amount of people that run up Gold Burst in that game is kind of astounding. it's just a very gutsy thing to do with your burst in any guilty gear. Ooh, okay, baits the burst but doesn't get the punish. And unfortunately gets picked up in the air. Force break disc Oki.
Certain people just can't help themselves, you know?
Certain
Especially
people.
When you have the glorious dragon installed as your pay.
Yeah. Oh, okay, here we go.
There was a game where Zucker literally...
Oh my God!
Started.
Yeah.
That destroyed that sounds about right.
Okay, the psychological damage done there has to be immense.
I mean, we're not really seeing it so far.
Okay, Oki. Touch. Loops. Footsies. Oh no, jumped right into Force Break Disc.
Clean follow-up off of it though, so back to neutral we go.
Okay, whiffs, 5D. Yeah, footsies again. Okay, Vulture, you have...
Alright, we all know and love.
Alright, Vulture, you have Burst. Okay, just spends it normal. I was wondering if he was going to do... This is a situation where if he actually does open up Milia, I think it should just be... She should just
block string is kind of interesting.
Yeah.
It wasn't like even like busting like a combo. It was just like doing block string.
This is some Sam Show neutral. There's a danger warning on both players because they have the same skill. Checks out. Spot dodges through Pim? Is she dead?
And the fastball. Not
oh, reset! Okay, alright. That's the game
that
on the board. Yeah, alright, so that's 5-2 now. What a good way to make a comeback there. What a perfect into IK. And then a good scramble to cement just one game means a pretty significant amount. Good dive kick. Yeah, that's the danger with Cliff. Cliff's big buttons and the amount of stun that he accrues. Even black beats are valid. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Sometimes black beats are more valid.
Yeah. And of course, Vulture has probably been studying all the fucking T5 stuff, so he knows when resets are real and like what to do there. And I posted like a clip to my Twitter that was just like, you know, my fellow Americans, I've discovered the secret to defeating Cliff. Just hit him. and it's just me doing,
so don't
like,
get hit.
It's just me doing Force Break Puffball with the IK on a cliff. And then in the replies, I put, T5, please don't post a touch of death, a jam specific touch of death in reply to this combo. Please, I beg you. Oh, okay. That was so fucked. Okay, so Vulture's back breaking might be the opportunity that Rensen needs there, but okay, he manages to get out of the corner. Well, touch. Yeah,
the
black
flip.
Beat. Oh, another tech. Trade. You have plenty of meter. Okay, tries to poke with full screen super.
Oh,
yeah.
Secret garden.
Yeah, did not FD that.
Really is actually the OG Heihyun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In a way.
That was very much a Fu Heihyun moment type of thing going on there. Heaven or hell. Duel. Let's rock.
Okay, here we go. Good spot dodge. Force the burst. 2D underneath disc. Yeah. 5P, but no combo. Oh no, flips into disc, bursts out.
Force the burst!
Again. Oh, good air throw! Yeah.
Nice.
Really impressive. Push break disc. Good reversal super. That's a lot of damage on the board, too. Doesn't cross up, keeps corner. Oh, again. Yeah.
This again, you can't smash on him.
It's I think Vulture kind of is aware that like disc is a potent like anti-air here. Yeah,
again.
See he RC'd in order to block it, but he got hit anyway. I think he got hit because he didn't have meter to air block it. Because he RC'd. He's trying to figure out how to navigate
RC it. And also like FD, like having the presence to do both. It's actually kind of tough sometimes.
He really wants to figure out the solution to, like, Rensen is playing floor as lava whenever Vulture, like, goes into the air with a flip or something. Okay, just goes for, oh no, drops the combo! Okay, we're sick.
Bad moon.
Okay, 7-2. We're moving right along here, folks.
Oh yeah.
Okay, yeah. Using Secret Garden to force Vulture to navigate around that projectile as Cliff. Good stuff, though. Forces a burst out of Rensen. Rensen dead angles, but gets hit with a spot dodge and the throw. This should be a dead million. Oh, okay. Whiffs.
Hey, gets out of there.
There we go.
Little bad position.
Okay. Turn up. Again. Yeah. Tried to slash back that.
Ambitious.
I don't know if the block lockout came in play there. Okay, yeah. A lot of good damage coming out from Vulture here. But, yeah, Tex out of the combo.
The 6P is doing so much good block.
Yeah. Rensen doing a much better job at... Unfortunately, Cliff is still a small body. But Rensen doing a really good job at trying to convert hits into... Ooh, okay. Does not get the burst bait.
shimmies the drill there.
That was really smart from Vulture. That was a calculated risk. All right, 7-3. Alright. Footsies. Really good pin. CK Bad Moon off of Force Break Disc Oki. Looking really impressive here. Good Abare. Forces Rensenware to back off. The two-touch, potentially? Okay, no. Rensenware jumps out. Oh, but here it comes. There we go. Yeah, Vulture getting some footing here.
Damage output.
Yeah. Dust loop. Oh,
conversion.
Doesn't get the, yeah.
Both gets semi-baited, though.
This looks like a perfect. This is gonna stun. Yeah. Okay. Really solid stuff here. Both players are playing really good. Don't let the scores, like, lie to you. Both players are playing really good. Yeah, Super Yari Noki tries to run out, gets counter hit. Again, yeah. Where are we going? Are you gonna see the double perfect here, Tux? Yes, you are.
Is it? Is this really a double perfect when you
yeah,
lose round one?
Yeah, that's a double perfect.
When you lose round, I don't count.
Yeah, that's a double perfect.
That's
you get two
perfect.
Perfects in a row. That's a double perfect.
That's not a double perfect.
Well,
you can't lose round one. You can't be losing round one.
That's a double perfect. I'm calling it a double perfect.
You can't lose round one.
It was two perfects in a row!
You can't lose round one.
Well, some people don't have high standards. Or standards as high as yours, as I should say.
The point is that the game was an absolute flawless crushing. It wasn't a flawless crushing, because you lose round one.
That's the download game. That's lulling them into a false sense of security.
Still not a double perfect.
Alright. Oh, so you get a good 62.
Two in a row at the very least. Although
yeah.
I think I am on Texas' side on this.
It was two in a row, though.
It was two in a row, but Barbaros is asking better than Shad.
Right. Okay. Footsies. Yeah. Vulture taking a big gamble just by dashing into whatever Rensenware has set up at mid to full screen. Oh, no! Okay. Ooh! Good reversal throw!
No.
Yeah, just gonna take the damage. Rensen flies out of the screen, but gets crossed up. Good chicken block on his XP. Oh no, the furthest range that 6P hit. Okay. Black beat. Into wall loop.
Using that double air dash to its full extent there. Yeah.
That's a lot of damage. Maybe maybe we don't have to watch out for Cliff. Maybe Milia is actually the real... Well, Milia was already a top tier character.
Yeah.
I'm not even gonna entertain that. Burst?
It only takes, you know... The 25th time of seeing Jason versus Blitz to get the message, right?
Yeah. Alright, Rensenware falls in and takes that game. Rensen is one game away from winning the first attempt. Vulture has seven more games, so we could see at least eight more games, but Rensenware wants to make this quick. Yeah, Rensen, Vulture has to win seven more games. To make this comeback. You know, I was worried that I was like, you know, I don't know if it should be a first to 10. First to 10 is going to be too long. But then I remember this is Guilty Gear XXAC+R. Oh, okay.
This is why plus all should be a best of five format.
There is a fucking post from some plus R players like saying like, yeah, you guys can't tell me that the damage is too high in the older games. When can you do this amount of damage to someone in the older games? You can't do it because it was like May like Touch of Death Exotto with high risk off of 5K or
Incidentally,
whatever.
Incidentally, this is plus all where everyone's a little bit tougher.
Yeah.
Imagine vanilla action core where everyone has like minus 20% of the life they do in this game.
Yeah, it would be insane. Rensen one round away from taking victory.
Not the Antios, yeah.
Good footsies. There we go.
Yep.
Okay. So Rensenware did it. This is Rensenware's revenge from the fifth place tiebreaker. But Rensenware wins 10-3, boiling JustVulture in oil. Good stuff to both players. We're not going to see the last of them. There's still more of them to see tonight. Because now we're going to get started with the 5v5. So, just as a reminder, let's go over the roster again. Let me pull up the roster real quick. So the roster is as follows. On Team Izzy, we have Izzy the captain, Joefish, Barbaros, and Wagner, and JustVulture. And on Team Jacob, we have Jacob the captain, Viper was a stand-in that got re-replaced by Dukjohn, who was the initial team member. Jacob, Dukjohn, McHerpyDerps, BeeBrother, and Rensenware. So we're gonna get started with the crew battle now. I'm gonna make sure that the teams are ready. I'm gonna wait until they, this is what I get for only playing Castlevania the past week. Alright, so we're gonna see, what happens next here. I'm gonna wait to see who these teams decide to send up first. I will remind you all of the rules of the crew battle. So this is a 5v5. Each player gets two lives. Each life is worth one game, not one set. So it's a first to one. The winning player cannot swap out. This is to prevent counterpicks. But otherwise, the players can go in any order they want. Incidentally, Team Izzy has been in their Discord chat this whole time, planning, practicing, and streaming. And Team Jacob has been very, has been kind of aloof, nonchalant about it. But I'm wondering what they're planning.
Jacob's been lost in the grilled cheese mines for the last hour. And I imagine dukjohn will literally not communicate or do anything outside of being in the set.
Yeah. Yeah, I wonder actually if Jacob thought that the first attempt was going to last longer.
Maybe.
Yeah. It's fine. It's fine though. We have plenty of time, so. Yeah, there was a theory that this would really just come down to either dukjohn or Joefish leading the charge for their respective teams. Since both, but really everybody on each team is very strong. Oh, okay. Jacob is in transit. Okay. All right. Looks like okay. So Jacob is on his way back to the setup. You three in the call. Rensenware, McHerpyDerps, BeeBrother, pick a champion. Alright. So I think really, if besides Jacob, who I guess is probably gonna wait to send out. They have to decide either if BeeBrother, McHerpyDerps, or Rensenware, or dukjohn goes first.
What if we had called this Mild West Tuning Exams instead of
that would be good. That would be good. I'm just not Naruto enough, but that would have been pretty good.
When we eventually do this for like Xrd or whatever.
Yeah.
We should do
we'll call it
there has to be
exam.
A written oh, section no. just like the tuning exams in the
Oh
series.
No.
Yeah.
How many flames of invul does Bam Evolver have?
Throw in like one question that requires you to do trigonometry about like jump angle or something like that.
Yeah. No. Venom is in the game.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Okay, so Rensen is gonna go on first, it seems, from Team Jacob. And it looks like, okay. Alright, this is gonna, alright, so this first set is gonna be Rensenware. Versus Joefish, it looks like. All right.
It's like we start off with the team battle early.
Yep. All right. So, rensenware representing Team Jacob. Joefish representing Team Izzy. So I'm gonna put in the overlay. I'm going to put on the score counter. I'm going to put 10 and 10. Those are the players' lives. All right. So each player has two lives each. And when both teams are down to zero lives, obviously that team is out.
Not smash or no stock sharing.
Yeah. I don't actually. If there were. Yeah. Oh boy. If there were any if there are any crew battles that do that, that's goofy. Don't do that.
It is really stupid. It just have people just not bother to play.
Okay.
Like, oh yeah, I'm the weakest person on the team. Let's just get that guy over there to take all my lives.
All right. So with a very, very, very clutch scramble there, but Rensen manages to mix Joe pretty substantially.
You know, I could almost see a rule set that could make that work. Where it's like, if you do that, then you have to spend two lives.
Right.
You have to spend two lives to counterpick that way.
Okay, good anti-air close slash. Yeah. Okay, hair car allows Rensen to also pick up a pin. Or corner to corner, but no full combo. Goes for Oki instead, but Rensen manages to get out. Rensen is really fragile right now. Yeah, there we go. Joefish had full resources there. Pretty difficult situation. Oh, okay, round start disc. No pickup. Again, no pickup off of pin turbo fall. Gets reversal thrown. Rensenware is showing a really good showing against someone that a lot of people were saying was one of the favorites to do well here. Bootsies. PK.
One at a time, though.
Yeah.
Oh, bust. That'll get you that.
There we go.
Fusion getting stuffed by the needle.
Okay, 2D. Again, yeah, pin. Pin doing a lot of work here.
Oh! DP.
Manages to block. Oh, okay.
Finds the Fujin and the Ulm. That'll do it.
There we go. Okay, that was really close. But Joefish takes the first win for Team Izzy. Alright. So now, Team Jacob has to decide who they're going to send next. Okay, it looks like they're gonna send, McHerpyDerps. Because McHerpyDerps left the call. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so McHerpyDerps, McHerpyDerps and Jacob, I think some of the other players are also from the same FGC local region. McHerpyDerps, also known for being one of the players who, like, entered the event and then immediately won it. very strong Faust in her own right, so we'll
Gold
see how this goes.
Dust!
Yeah, if... Okay, that's a lot of food, and that's a lot of mini Fausts there that keep Joefish
guessing.
Yeah,
but the poison damage is doing plenty of walk.
Yeah, spicy zoning, as they say. I think a candy bar there, or some food item, might have actually kept Joefish alive a little bit longer, but it's okay. Yeah, this looks really overwhelming here. Really good area there. Good meaty as well. Good air throw. Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of Anji play here that I don't normally see from this character.
Well, you don't really see Anji that much.
Especially, yeah, especially in this matchup. Wow, okay. Alright, so we'll see if McHerpyDerps can close this out, or if Joefish will continue his sweep. Yeah, really good items here. Items and love preventing Joefish from escaping the corner. Interesting cross-up situation there.
Fuji, the pogo stick!
Yeah. Ooh!
Trades win! Dodges the candy ball?
I think that's it, yeah. Okay, McHerpyDerps takes a life off of Joefish.
I think dodging the candy ball was not good there.
Yeah. That would have...
Instead of just running in and doing a regular button.
Okay. Alright.
Punish the landing on that jump.
Alright, McHerpyDerps avenges Rensen's first life. Yeah, Joefish pointed that out. I wanted to point that out too. McHerpyDerps crossed up in the corner and then side switched with J2K, I think. And then that forced Joefish to turn around. And then Joefish got blown up by items that were facing behind him. Even though he was blocking correctly the first way. Alright, so we'll see how this goes. Team Izzy figuring out who they're going to send next. Barbaros, okay.
Oh, I forgot to pay out the prediction.
Yeah, give everybody the channel points. Alright, so Barbaros is an interesting case. Barbaros was one of our reserve roster members. He did win a Mild West, but he's not banned from Mild West. He won the Mild West round robin that we did the week of Frosty Fastings, where there were only a handful of people who entered. So we put him on the reserve roster with the premise being that he's free to enter another Mild West and be banned for real. If he wants to be.
Low turnout, yeah. not the best showing, really.
Yeah. So, but, I mean, still obviously very skilled Slayer player in his own right. Gets the mix, gets the burst bait on McHerpyDerps.
And then big bang upper, big damages.
Alright, McHerpyDerps has plenty of meter to work with here.
Yeah, but you gotta actually do something with it.
Goes for a 6P instead. Ooh! Reverse super!
Whoa.
That almost killed! Oh! Tried to FRC for the combo after! Oh boy!
Tried to big bang up, but that just put the player in a bad spot there.
Yeah, everyone was saying to watch out for Joefish and dukjohn, but McHerpyDerps has some very wild gameplay coming out here.
Crosswise heal into full combo.
Sweep. Oh, okay, throws the 5D, yeah.
Another crosswise heal. Makes sense, that is the anti of the set.
Every game so far has been really back and forth. These are kind of crazy. Okay.
Fancy help throw yeah, mix
dash into throw. McHerpyDerps forced to block when she was six. Ooh, there we go.
Oh, the 5D invul. That walk. Yeah.
He's not ending a knockdown, but that still gets them out of the corner. So she gets to go out, and it gets to continue its pressure. Yeah.
At the bust.
Yeah. What could this be? That was could have been better.
Dude's on over there.
That's the luck of the draw.
Oh, 6-H.
Still, man, the fact that you have to respect any items at all, really good. Still has to respect meteors. Again, yeah. Okay, too many Robo-Kais here. You have to watch out. And then meteors are coming down too.
Yeah.
Oh, ah, ah!
Oh, crossway's
still! Oh, okay,
blown.
Yeah. the bomb is still there. Okay. Okay. McHerpyDerps on a streak here. Yeah, people were saying, oh, you gotta watch out for Joefish. You gotta watch out for dukjohn. Okay, Wagner is next. Wagner immediately up next. I believe Wagner is also PNW. So I don't know who Wagner is going to play here. So, okay, ABBA.
What did Elven Shadow's record with Skeletal Minion end up looking like?
I think Elven has the winning record, but he doesn't believe that it's a winning matchup for Faust. Sure. He just thinks that he's just good against Skeletal Minion. I think that's what it is. If I remember correctly. Wagner is really good. He's got a good control of both characters. I guess he believes that ABBA is probably better in the matchup than Chip. I mean, we've seen Skeletal Minion
is somehow more stable of a character,
yeah.
Despite like ABBA's like mechanics looking less stable.
Ooh, okay, yeah, this is where it comes into play.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, McHerpyDerps just saves Burst for the next game.
Like ABBA has more buttons that you just have to like hold or be just completely blown up. Where Chip is like, yeah, if you mess up,
too many pots.
Big deal.
Too many pots.
God.
Two of them.
Both mini pots have successfully saved McHerpyDerps' life.
Oh, but blown up by his own bomb.
Aggressive bird. Ah! Yeah. No! Oh, she tried to show off! Okay, please don't die!
Messed up the feint!
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. It got around. It got around anyway. We're in there. Oh, that's scary though.
Yo, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Items to keep ABBA away. Really good force break command dash.
2K
drops the juggle.
Button.
All right, key grab.
Finds it.
Here it begins.
Okay, there we go. That's the beginning.
Short reset
each hit
into
from ABBA
overhead.
Always just so terrifying.
Yeah. Ooh, okay. Force break chop.
Especially with the wrist being pushed up.
Yeah. Okay. Force break chop gets it out of the corner.
Soon. Oh, that
oh,
was
they,
all of it.
Yeah. Wow. No. Both of them got punished for doing like literally anything. Okay. Yeah. Wagner forced to respect pop. Mini pot.
Fucking mini pot. Whoa. Oh my god.
Why? How has she gotten three mini pots?
Okay. Had to get out of Guldahar there.
Ooh, Jesus.
Oh, those. The peapot just getting.
To pee with.
I'm amazed.
It just sucked.
Oh, this is the last hit. It's scramble.
Okay, get
ooh,
the hit. That's it.
There we go. Okay, McHerpyDerps' short streak has ended. Wagner, in a very close scramble.
I've never seen that many mini pots in one set.
Very close scramble there. Okay, so Wagner stays on. It looks like they're gonna send BeeBrother up next.
Let's rock!
Alright, so Zappa... So BeeBrother is very novel because he's not only like one of the only Zappas that we see... Well, yeah, he's... That's really it. He's one of the only Zappas that we've seen in Wild West. And in Wild West, really. We don't get to see people like Hellsap, etc. often, so... Yeah, so he's got sword, but he got knocked down, so now he has to, rotate into triplets. Oh, Wagner dropped the Goku OTG, but it's okay, because...
That's okay, anyway, Zappa just dies!
Was that an OTG, or is he trying to, like...
I think there was some sort of...
super or something like that.
It could have been, like, a very distant read, but I think it was supposed to be a continuation of the combo.
Trying to like DP DP type of thing going on.
Yeah, yeah. The mochi meaty TK DP.
Okay, I like these double jumps here. BeeBrother is actually having an uncharacteristically hard time keeping Wagner from getting in here, but a knockdown
like,
will do
the damage
that.
Damage is still going only one way. You don't actually have to hit. Often, you just have to be the only one being hit.
Yeah, Spence burst. But oh, he gets back in again.
Why are you not getting the hit?
Okay. Yeah, unfortunately, BeeBrother is not able to capitalize off of getting the really good sword pulls as much as he liked, and so Wagner will take that game. So now we gotta. So now Team Jacob has got to figure out who they're gonna send next. They have dukjohn in the wings, who they could send, unless dukjohn just doesn't show.
They could also. Everybody has two lives, right? So
they could go back in. Yeah, I don't know where. If Jacob gets back miraculously, they could send Jacob. We'll see how this goes. They're gonna deliberate here.
I wonder if they're trying to figure out how to
get
dukjohn.
Yeah. Okay, is Brenson gonna? Yeah, all right. There we go.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, Jacob is back, so we're all good. Okay. So here's what I'll do also. Okay, there he is.
Miraculously, the contract is sealed.
Alright. Now, okay, so. Again, broken record, but dukjohn was the other player that everybody was insisting that you have to watch out for. If it wasn't Joefish, it was dukjohn. And I think with good reason. Because dukjohn was one of the players who notably graduated Wild West plus R, and then immediately double eliminated Jason Riot the following Wild West. So we've got Santa Cliff coming out here, gets anti-air by 5p, no key grab combo ender. Cliff is too small.
Cliff is just weird. Okay, finds the hit.
First.
Blocks the bus, but doesn't really get punished off of it. No punish for that bot dodge. Too far away to do the attack.
Okay, footsies. Oh, shit. Ha! The trade! I don't actually know
now
who
Goku
won that. Oh, okay.
This should be it. Oh!
Gets out. Really well-timed meaty there on the burp. Okay, dukjohn has to be really careful here. This does not look that close. Oh!
Oh! Get the egg button.
Yeah. Really, really good air-to-air to keep Wagner from getting out of the corner. Wagner has been the source of a lot of scrambles.
Moloha here. Finds the 5D. Not the no wheel combo for that one.
Dukjohn looking to end Wagner's streak. Wagner still has burst and some Moroha and 50 meter. I imagine he's going to. Okay, can he wake
there
up and go? Yeah, there we go,
the Goku.
Goku.
Last
shot. Oh
split.
Shit!
Oh my god!
Danzai, though!
Okay, Danzai through the taunt Oki! If
not
you can. Yeah,
kill.
There we go. Okay, gets an amount of health back. Is this gonna be enough to allow you to survive against Dukjohn?
No, wow.
Okay.
The dive does it.
Yeah, dive kick will take it. So. We have been totally even. This entire The longest anybody has survived is 2 games. Okay. JustVulture has said that he's gone even against Dukjohn before. So I guess send a cliff to kill a cliff.
Yeah, they should have done that in the Mineco.
Yeah, they should have done that in the Mineco. I guess they did. Well, I mean, no spoilers, but I guess there was a scene where they did kill a cliff, correct? Really? Like, if. In a manner of speaking. In a new Mineco.
Did they?
Yeah, in episode 2, right? And, with the shrine. Would you call. Does that count?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Both players have already spent bursts. Okay, so Dukjohn. Dukjohn is the blue cliff, and JustVulture is the white and pink cliff. I mean, this overlay is gonna get really crowded. This is a very, like, let them fight ass matchup.
Mm-hmm.
I think a lot of people are getting very kind of distraught over Cliff lately. Yeah, okay. JustVulture doing a really good job at locking Dukjohn down. They both have the same tools. They both seem to be able to use them well against each other. Oh, shit! Okay, Force Break's over the Taunt Oki, so... I've also been always distraught over Cliff Saison.
MD gets busted!
Out!
Oh, that is some jump...
What a comeback!
Footsie.
Yeah.
That is what we call vertical footsie.
Reversal Super! Okay.
Can't spot dodge that.
Alright, we're getting into the thick of round 3 here. Both cliffs are going back and forth. Chat, this is a reminder, the players who have already played on both teams are Barbaros, Joefish, JustVulture, Wagner, and BeeBrother, McHerpyDerps, Rensenware, and JustVulture. I think the only players who have not gone yet are the team captains.
Oh.
Okay.
Might have to now.
Yeah. Okay, so Dukjohn takes a game off JustVulture. So the last player who has not been sent out is Izzy. On Team Izzy. Alright, here she is. So now... Again, so Izzy is the team captain. Izzy has switched to Cliff. But I believe she also... I mean, I don't know if she's going to go into the mirror. Okay, I guess so. Alright, so Izzy is the black cliff, Dukjohn is the white cliff. Dukjohn trying to show her who's boss. Locked down. Oh, good air throw. Bursts out. Yeah. Flips right over taunt. Gets caught in the backdash. Okay. If Dukjohn wins this here, this will be the first moment, the first time that someone has had a win streak longer than, longer than two. Yeah, there are three cliffs. Two of them are on the same team. It was not supposed to be like that. Oh, goodness. That is... That is wild. Okay.
Pulling ahead.
Yeah, so we'll see here.
Everyone's on their last life now on Team Izzy.
Everyone here on Team Izzy is now one on a single stock. They're going to have to figure out how to eliminate. Okay, so they're going to send JustVulture back in. They probably believe that JustVulture has the best chance. Of settling the score. Okay, oh, these colors are great. Thank you for the subscription, Squid Kid Gaming. So Dukjohn is the blue, JustVulture is the pink. Vulture gets Dukjohn to spend his burst. Okay, and also sidesteps Dukjohn's block string. Oh my goodness.
Full trade.
Reversal super. Knockdown, there we go. Okay. Alright, Vulture, that's the round that he needed. This way he can have an extra round to play with, but he obviously wants to send Dukjohn back crawling to the rest of the team. We'll see how this goes. Footsies. Burst.
Ah.
Okay, yeah. I like Vulture is just committing to the safest options possible. I guess, like, recognizing what Cliff can do to himself.
Yeah.
I think this is a stun, though.
There's some really odd, blind spots in Cliff's moves, actually, when it comes to against Cliff.
Yeah. Okay, spot dodge, but gets hit with a delay. Crossed up. I think we're gonna see a stun again. Yeah.
There's the stun! Oh, so much damage on 6H!
Oh, goodness gracious. Alright, Vulture. Vulture's got it.
Blocks
take
the...
Oh, again!
Just smashing spot dodge.
Yeah. Really, really high risk gameplay there. So that's it. Vulture is out of lives. That was a calculated risk. But now Dukjohn is on a win streak. Here we go. Okay, Joefish clearly dreading having to play against Dukjohn.
The Cliff Menace. Round start 5D. Like, yeah. Into the knockdown. Ish? No, not really.
This was the... Oh, wow! Fujin's right through burst.
Gets the throw.
Oh, goodness.
Tons of damage.
Is this stun? Black meat and stun?
Not quite.
Not on a block. Oh, okay. Ooh, goodness. Again, no OTG. 5 TP OTG. Not enough. Joefish is sitting real pretty here.
2D.
Okay, Fujin. There we go.
Believe that Anji's voice actor also did Nikki Kasara.
Yeah, who looks exactly like Anji.
Who looks exactly like him.
Chat, if you haven't watched Macross 7, you should. This is an unironic.
No.
I am 100%. I am 100% unironically.
Macross is a classic.
I am 100% unironically endorsing Macross 7 as Joefish ends dukjohn's win streak. Holy. Okay, that was good. Okay, here we go. Okay, Jacob's gonna go in. Jacob's gonna go in to play against Joefish. Jacob, the team captain, finally making an appearance. Apparently, Jacob is not at home right now. He's playing on someone else's PC. Alright. Here we go. Yeah, if Joefish can... So if Joefish can take Jacob's stock here, then everybody on Team Jacob will be down to their final stock. This is shaping up to be a really nice and clean short event. I should have thought of ways to elongate this event.
This is enough. I don't know, what else do we have for like a third event?
I don't know. As I should, I really don't know. That's a good point.
I made some suggestions. I don't remember what they were anymore.
Rensenware says in chat, I think if you elongated it, Vulture would be driven insane. Okay, Joefish stopping Jacob's approach.
Like, yeah, Grand Viper, on, Stun Dip was pretty good against Fujin.
Yeah.
Unlike Grand Viper, you can't just do it as easily.
Ooh, RC? This is... Ooh, okay. Stop Speed Sever.
Is that Wake Up Force Break Greed Sever?
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I guess why not? Oh, no. Okay. Last
Fujin
legs?
Lean past, blasting through the attempted stop sign.
Okay. Alright.
Making it close again.
Yeah. Everyone on Team... Okay, Team Jacob now only has... one life apiece. Team Izzy is down a whole player already, and they also are all one life apiece. Saizon insisting that Force Break Greedsever has involved.
But does it?
Alright. Dustloop.com? Four frames of strike involved.
Oh, so it's like my breath. My
you calm down over there, kiddo.
Alright, well, now you need to make Wake Up Bandit Revolver the standard.
Yeah.
Don't I still do that?
Okay.
Do I not do that?
You don't do that enough.
Do I not
you
do
don't
that?
You don't do that enough for how often you insist it's good. Relative to how much
I'm
you insist,
sure relative.
Listen, relative to how much you insist it's a real reversal, you do not do it enough. That's what I think. That is the consensus. All right, BeeBrother coming back in here.
I mean, I could wake up like bat, like wake up super, like wake up, what, well, the wake up 2D, wake up volcanic viper. Why not just wake up volcanic viper if I'm gonna do a wake up dumb move? Soul has too many good options.
They should nerf Soul, actually. Okay, immediate round start press buttons. Sword is now gone. BeeBrother needs a summon. There we go. Okay, triplets.
Finds the ween.
Can you wall out Anji with Stooges?
Pally, not.
Not, yeah. Okay, reversal super into Stooges again. This is probably... I mean, it's saying something that Rao is his worst summon, but this is probably, like, his second worst summon.
Actually, but, like, it's still pretty good.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, Flash Kick Dog gets stuffed out, too. Joefish is not afraid of, Zappa.
It's a good button.
Yeah.
I'm glad that Strive Fujin is not that button.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Pulling his way in with force
breaks. Maybe he needs it? Does Audrey need it?
He's doing just fine.
Yeah, he's doing okay. Yeah. Run up, tick throw. Okay, low, it's RC. Is this gonna kill? Yeah.
Yeah. It's even.
Okay, yeah. BeeBrother is now eliminated. We are now even on stocks. So, yeah. But currently even stock count, even player count. Joefish now has the longest streak. Since dukjohn popped on. We're gonna see what they decide. Okay, Rensen is coming back on. Can anyone stop this fighting machine?
That was, like, a very flat delivery.
It's not my fault. Okay, burst out. Alright, now we're gonna play, now we're in Milia time. Whispered Disc?
It's always Milia time.
Oh, just a bar is right out. I don't believe in, getting mixed up. I don't believe in high, low, left, right. Okay, but Rensen has the Burst Spin on deck. With 6p, unfortunately. Does Rensen
back
have
to neutral.
Pin? He's not using it. I have to assume he doesn't have it. I don't see where it went after he threw it that one time. Okay. Yeah. 4H into the corner. There we go.
That thing.
Yeah. All right. Rensen makes Joefish bleed.
Fujin versus Wall.
That's a
handshake.
Okay, Rensen puts Joe back in the corner. Joe has not gotten a hit yet. Another roll through into throw. Secret Garden Oki. Empty into low.
Another roll.
This is the last chance. Last chance, Joe. You have to spend burst now or never. Shorter combo in order to beat out burst.
It.
Into a perfect.
Gang looped three times with the same opener.
Joefish is out. Three players left. Three lives.
I
Okay, Joefish is trying to say GG's to Rensen, and Rensen is trying to say, I don't know if you can say it was GG's, because he kept spamming roll, and I guess he feels that he cheated Joefish out of the win. Okay, Rensen versus Barbaros. Oh my goodness. I think basically every player has like some sort of win or like win condition. And really they can all clutch it out against each other here. Barbaros with 100 meter to burn in the first 20 seconds. If you touch Milia, she's dead. Roll again.
The tricky part is the first. The antecedent must be fulfilled to get the consequence.
Pussies. Five P but no confirm. Just a kind of truncated anti-air. Oh, okay.
Okay, finding it.
Yeah. Just burning it on a bunch of force breaks. Rensen is now knocked down. There we go.
That's it.
Okay, one round away from eliminating rensenware. They're gonna keep going back and forth, back and forth.
Ten.
Okay.
Wouldn't he protect pin?
Big steppy. Yeah.
The game.
We're playing tower defense. Against, yeah, every time Rensen just goes in, you get hit with the stomp. Oh.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Okay, there keep going.
It was having a moment.
Yeah, I wonder if that was just on our end.
Steam is, oh! Big Bang being out the Lush Shake, boss fight.
Oh, caught with the air-to-air. Rensen just double back. Oh, but doesn't take the opportunity to get in the pin. Okay, just kind of greedy. Just like, okay, I want to knock down into
the
loops.
There's the pin.
Yeah, there we go.
He
okay,
gets
here
the pin
we go.
Connection here. One more chance.
Oh, 2P. Oh,
bad
shit!
Moon. Oh, burst!
What an amazing burst bait. Okay, even round right now, but Barbaros lost that burst, so we'll see what happens here. Secret Garden Noki, yet Hilo
like
Millie
time.
Stun? One. Oh no!
Oh, Rensen? Big Bang not going under the loop, the disc enough.
Barbaros has now been eliminated. Oh, okay, wow. They rematched. Wait, okay, no, that was it. That was it. You guys can just IK each other or get out, I don't know. Okay,
they're too used to just pushing the go next.
Yeah,
button.
They really were like, oh man, I really want to fucking go again.
Go next, go next!
Yeah, okay, disconnected. Alright, Joefish has now been eliminated. Joefish has now been eliminated. Barbaros has now been eliminated. JustVulture has now been eliminated. Am I counting this correctly?
Yeah, so currently, Barb, Joe, and Vulture on Team Izzy have been eliminated.
Right.
And then on the other team, BeeBrother is the only one that's been eliminated, I believe.
Yeah, okay. Alright, so here we go. So we've got Wagner coming out.
Heaven or hell? Duel. One. Let's rock.
I think everybody has had like a lot of people have had like different kind of perceptions on who would be like the player to watch out for on any given team. I think the tonight is the night that we'll see if Wagner can put a stop to Rensenware's dominance. But even if we disclude, or like, don't include the first attempt that we saw earlier. Oh my god!
Well, did get eliminated early on the first life.
Even if we don't, include the first attempt, Rensenware has had the most perfects tonight out of everybody who's played.
Dude. But it is a Milia thing to do that, kind of. By contrast, Abba is mechanically incapable of such a thing.
It was also just that everybody saw the rosters that I posted, like, for the past couple weeks, and they're like, oh yeah, it's gonna be Joefish sweet. Oh yeah, it's gonna be dukjohn sweet. Like, you're not, like, the rest of these players are hella crazy.
Yeah.
Oh
what if,
no.
What if you just render your opponent not able to play the game at all? Last chance. This is it. Captain gotta carry it all the way now.
Yeah, so this is it. So Izzy now has to carry her whole team on her back.
Heaven or hell? Duel. One, let's
roll. Vulture with probably one of the most powerful flexes, especially if you consider all the dumbass Twitter discourse lately.
Has there been Twitter discourse?
There's been Twitter discourse about how hard it is to date in the FGC, and a lot of dudes in the FGC just don't realize that they're crusty. Then no one wants to date them. Oh, V-Sync. Okay. Yeah. So Izzy got that round and then it desynced. I'm gonna have them both burn burst and then just replay that round. Well, Izzy's gonna IK, but after they both burn burst.
Heaven or hell, duel. One, let's rock.
Yeah. Yeah, he didn't see it. Okay, Rensen.
Well then.
Yeah, I'm just not gonna count this game. Rensen was supposed to burst and didn't. They both had burn burst into the real round one, so we'll just redo this.
Last game, part three.
Yeah, we'll do the third time's a charm. We'll redo this. This doesn't count. Oh, yeah. Win.
I wonder if he goes like, please just let me out
of jail. I want you both
to
burst in the round one redo. Yeah. Okay, so now both of you burst. There we go. Izzy gets this round. Yeah. That plays a blow up. We have to do the best we can in order to recreate somewhat fair conditions. Alright, now this is the real game. Okay, we get the touch here. Black beat into the corner. Spot dodge. Interesting trade. Dive kick.
Amun gets punished with drill.
Yeah, okay. Footsies, 6p. Goes through the Secret Garden Oki. Looks like this could be it. Okay, Rensen gets burst back. Okay, 2D will take it. Alright, so after we finally get to replay this correctly, Izzy eliminates Rensen.
Izzy eliminates Rensen 2-6?
Yeah.
Or something.
Okay, Jacob is now going to go up against Izzy. So we're now going to have the team captains fight. Now, if you remember, if any of you saw the team selection stream, Jacob lost that 3-1. They played a first to three, and Jacob lost that. But Jacob only needs to win this one game, but also so does Izzy. So it's going to be kind of tough here. Okay. Footsies. We'll see if Jacob is... Oh my fucking god. Oh my fucking god! Wait. Okay, 2D. Taunt. Dead angle. Again! Another spot dodge. Trying to work on the two touch. Okay, apparently McHerpyDerps told Jacob to do this. Okay, is he? Jacob was actually playing really, like, nice and patient here. Or to kind of force Izzy to...
Stop saying, yeah. Saying nope to that.
Oh, well, but throw on the landing.
And drill! This should
Ooh,
be a
this
huge
should,
punish.
Yeah. Oh, not going out to kill. No pickup there. No OTG. Footsies. Stop sign.
Well,
yeah,
stop sign.
Yeah.
Wanting to... Deal with these, Stun the hedge faster
okay.
than taunt.
Okay, okay.
Also,
all
this
right.
goes through the taunt.
Jacob, one round away from scoring a win over Team Izzy. Spot dodge.
Spot dodge in the throw.
DP.
Okay, DP. Into somewhat of a combo.
Oh no. Okay, forced to spend burst when he was 6. Into a throw. Izzy now has him in the corner. She could kill off of this, I think. Okay, yeah, dead angle's
dead
out.
Dead angle. Okay.
Wake up burst.
Finds the throw.
Oh, shit! What?!
That was sick.
That worked out totally! Okay, but this is still a big gamble. Risk is really high. Anti-air. Counter hit. One more scramble, good air throw. RC.
I was actually expecting another spot dodge.
Double jumps over
EX
stun it.
The RC came out.
Another. Oh, Jesus.
Oh. Black beat.
Okay, both players want this so bad.
Multi-mix-up.
Okay, there. The spot dodge actually works. Forces Jacob to burst again. Wake up, RTL! Get stuffed
it.
By taunt! This puts you
yeah,
in a pretty bad spot. Yeah. Oh no.
Next.
Oh no.
Into knockdown.
Oh,
into
that's it.
Dizzy.
That's it. That's
yeah.
it. Okay, Jacob is now eliminated. So, Izzy clutches out the team captain fight. There are two players left on Team Jacob.
Coming down to the wire.
It's if I remember incorrectly, it's McHerpyDerps and dukjohn.
That is correct.
These are
this is the fucking gauntlet, man.
Yeah, Izzy has to win against both of these really, really strong Mild West graduates here. this is a tough hill to climb. But if she does this successfully, she will have carried her entire team on her back through like four players. So it'll be really nuts. But we're gonna... Okay, dukjohn has been sent in. The dukjohn warning has been...
Yeah, they've lit the beacon.
Yeah.
They've shown the duck beacon on the night sky.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a whack-ass palette.
Okay, so dukjohn is the graphite color.
This is a weird-ass color.
Yeah,
that's
really
weird. I've never
seen
one before.
Okay, Izzy looking really good here against dukjohn, actually. Oh, but dukjohn gets something started.
Yeah. 5D now. It's even.
Okay, footsies. Dive kick, committal, RC to stay safe on block string. Ooh, gets clipped. Spot dodge, whoa. No punish into
one
air
more.
Throw. Yeah, one more hit here. Okay. There we go. Okay. Alright, dukjohn is now one round away from winning it for Team Jacob, but we've seen Izzy come back from this literally in the last game, so.
This feels like to be a bad cliff with a gun, you need
a good cliff with a gun, yeah.
Yeah. Something like that. Bad guy with a cliff, good guy with a cliff, that's more like it.
The loops, the 5D loops. Run up gold first! No! She's gonna get punished for that!
Supa is basically dragging gun.
Yeah. Oh no! That's it! She's dead! That's it!
Yeah!
Team Jacob wins! Wow. Okay, McHerpyDerps asks which is which, so who is the good cliff with a gun there? And who is the bad cliff?
I don't know.
I think
the victor just gets to be the protagonist.
Yeah, right.
I think that's how that works. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah,
history
is written by
the winners. The team of lesser cliffs is the protagonist, the underdogs on account of having less cliff on their team.
Right, yes.
Yeah, that.
All right, so that does it for everybody.
dukjohn posts in the Discord for the first time in like 6 months.
GGs!
That was pretty incredible.
Yeah, that was
really
good.
That was really down to the wire.
Oh, boy. Yeah, that was really nice, clean, fun. I'm glad... All right, for real, I'm glad everything ran on time. I'm glad everyone was here. I'm glad we managed to get everybody here. And I'm glad we managed to make this a success. So, first of all, again, I want to thank Formal Eli and Appreciative Walrus, who's also in chat. Thank you guys for the 50 and 40, respectively. We now have a $150 prize pool, so everyone's gonna get paid out. I'll do like a 60-40 split or something, but everyone is gonna earn something for this. So this will be really, really good. But thanks to everybody who's been playing, who's been showing up for Mild West and WNF plus R for the past over all, like what 2021, 2020, almost 2 years now. That's crazy. We've been running Mild West plus R for exactly a year. This feels like a really nice capstone on the plus R event. Izzy, thank you for using some of the coupon codes as well. Oh boy, yeah. So this is just to be a little sincere here. We have been doing this for a while, and I was really worried that we wouldn't be able to pull this off. But it ended up being a lot easier than I thought. I had a lot of contingencies. I had like 10 different people that I had lined up to replace everybody in the tournament if they couldn't show up. I had like a lot of stuff. But I wanted this to be really fun. I wanted this to be like a... I wanted this to kind of just show off like the talent that we don't really get to see a whole lot. Because they get kind of overshadowed by the Jason Riots and the Blitzes and the Jacob Pats and the Elven Shadows and stuff. So I really appreciate everybody who has made Mild West what it is. Thanks again to everyone should thank my co-host Kimberly. Because she makes running these events way, way easier for me.
I will give that praise, but this one was almost entirely your doing. you did, like, all of the wrangling for this one.
Well, yeah, I can do all the wrangling for these so that you do, like, half or more of the work for all of the other shit that we do here, so... but yeah. So, everybody, please thank Dedipus in the Discord or in the chat, whatever, for all of these. She also streams the Mild West Strive, so if you're not following her on Twitch, you really should. Twitch.tv/Dedipus. We're gonna keep doing these, so I don't know, the next one for Plus R will be like a year out, just to be clear. But we're gonna...
There's not enough stuff left.
Yeah, but we're gonna... But we're gonna do these for Rev 2 and for Strive. Whenever we have enough graduates from those events to put together a big exhibition like this.
June is a fifth week month.
Yeah.
We'll have to think of something to do that for then.
Yeah, we'll have to figure out what we're gonna put as the event there. So everybody wants Blaze Blue. From all the polls that we've done, everybody wants a Central Fiction event. So we'll keep that in mind.
After June, it's November, the next 5 weeks.
Yeah. I don't really know what else to say. Okay, Elo, thank you for the $25 direct contribution. This is a nice, hefty pot. Everybody here is getting paid.
This is kind of interesting. Somehow, next year, February is a 5 week.
Yeah, that's funny.
February.
That's funny.
Wait, what? Huh?
They're adding a 32nd day to February. I don't know if you know that.
No. It's leap year next year.
Yeah.
So it's the 1st and the 29th of February. The February 29th doesn't usually exist, but it does next year. So there's a five week February next year.
That's beautiful.
I guess I will say this. I'm not going to go into like big detail, but it's been for me personally, it's been like a rough like week or like couple of weeks because I've had to deal with... some really heavy personal stuff. I'm not gonna get into that on Twitch because this is a very parasocial platform. But I do want to just say that, without Kim and without Tux and without the community that comes through to help us to put on a good show for us, my life would be very different, I think. This has been a lot of fun, and I really like that we, as Wild West Guilty Gear, have been able to leave a mark on the history of this game and cultivate the community where these players can come through and have fun. So I think that ends my sincere rambling. So I'll sign us off now. Okay, so we're gonna turn the tables on Oxycetylene. We're gonna go raid him for a change. So they're doing, I think they're doing NKO, which is their intermediate Rev 2 bracket. When you get to Oxycetylene, I don't know how to spell that. Oxyacetylene, be sure to tell them the cow sent you. I've been Light the Iron Man. I was joined again by my co-host Kimberly.
That's me.
And my co-commentator and eternal rival Tuxdev.
I'm sad I didn't get to Grand Viper U yesterday, but I was at work.
Next,
you can pick something other than a Wednesday.
Next week will be a regular Mild West Plus R. So if you like this event and you want to play in one of these, show up next week for Mild West Plus R. It'll be a Swiss intermediate bracket, as long as you're not a top player or as long as you have not graduated from a similar event. You are free to enter. So please show up next week if that interests you. Otherwise, I'll have Bill Clinton sign you guys off. As always, stay safe, stay healthy, and play some Guilty Gear.
And here's one that the most unbelievable of all. It says, kill your friends guilt-free.